What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo. And in today's video, we are checking out the artist Dana Paola. I really hope I said that right. I'm not sure. We are checking out, I think it's three songs. So this is Kala 2, Caprichosa, A Un Beso. Oh my god, I'm sure that I butchered that just now, so I apologize in advance. I am super stoked to check this out. I don't know really what to expect here, but I imagine it's going to be really great because Brenda from Patreon requested this. Brenda usually has some really badass recommendations, so I'm stoked to check this out. Yeah, let me know in the comment section if this is an artist that you really enjoy, and yeah, Brenda, thanks for the support. Okay, I'm going to dive into this because, yeah, let's just do it. This is fucking tight already. Oh, that instrumental. Okay, I love that. I don't love you anymore. I'm tired of hearing that you're gonna change. Your hypocrisy is, I'm over it. You shut up. Okay, the visuals of this are so fucking good. Okay, I fucking love the vocals of this so much. And when you have a beat like this, it is so mesmerizing to get to dive into a song like this because, yeah, obviously I'm reading the translations because I don't speak this language, right? So I'm reading the translations, but like, I don't feel like I'm missing anything. Like, I feel like I'm so into this beat. I'm hearing her vocals, which sounds so good over this. And then I get to hear the attitude that is in the lyricism, which is essentially, look, I'm not waiting for you anymore. You're never going to change. You just shut up. Like, you shut up. I'm moving on with my life. Ooh! That run is so fucking good. This fucking instrumental. I wish I could pull off an outfit like that. You know I'd fucking wear that. Okay, I love this song for so many reasons. Obviously, the instrumental is fucking everything. I can't believe this song. I mean, this song, maybe it's huge, but I can't believe, just based off that alone, like, they should be playing this everywhere. Two, her vocals are so great, and I love to hear it in this style because you do get a lot of that almost like whispering moments, like very breathy vocals, which I think adds to the overall vibe of this track, as well as just like the approach vocally to the lyrics, which are the best thing ever because this song has so much attitude. It's not a song about being heartbroken that this person sucks or being sad that they won't change. Like, that's not what we're getting here. Lyrically, the song is saying, hey, shut the fuck up. I'm not interested in hearing your bullshit about how you're going to be a better person and yada, yada, yada. Some people are all talk. And she's saying, I'm living my life better because you aren't here with your bullshit. And the just absolute like domination she brings into this video just makes all of it fucking 10 times harder and so good. Okay. The next track is Caprichosa. Caprichosa. Yes. Have to have the middle finger. Okay, why do I feel like I'm just gonna fucking love this artist? I love these styles. Ya tengo siete y no cinco sentidos, 14 vidas, no muchos amigos y no, no guardo rencor. She just seems so cool. Okay, I already have to say, this is the second track now where the lyrics have so much attitude that revolve around the power of yourself and not relying on other people to make you happy. So in the first one, we've got somebody that's obviously full of shit, always trying to pretend that they're going to be something better. And she's saying, no, fuck you. I'm not interested in hearing it. I don't care about it anymore. I'm happy. In this song, it's this very like powerful presence of, I get what I want. I can do whatever I want in my life. I have the power to control all of the things that I manifest in my life, including the power over you to decide what I want you to do. And I think that there's something so like, I'm going to use the word power because the power behind this sort of confidence really will take you to a whole new level. I think this is something very important to have in life anyway. So it's really cool to hear it here, especially with an instrumental like this. Again, love the vocals, love the lyrics, love the instrumental. These fucking outfits too. Okay, I fucking love her personality. Look at that. I set the rules and instructions. Like, there is no fucking, you don't get to just come here and decide. Like, I am taking ownership of my life and everything that is in it. I fucking love just the dance vibe of this instrumental. Says, like, you better fucking, this needs to happen, otherwise I'm gonna go find anyone. As soon as I change my mind, I'm gone. I love her demeanor. Like, this attitude is everything to me. I feel like we need more people like this. And I love the puppy. Okay, so this is obviously, hold on, let me see if that had a date on it. Oh, there's no, really? So this song, it feels really familiar. For some reason, I felt like this artist might be like from maybe several years ago, but this artist actually seems like super like new, right? And I love that because I'm loving this sound so much. And I feel like when you get a chance to have a artist like this in the current like day and age, it's always going to be such a fucking big deal because I love the attitude that she's bringing to this. Again, we're getting another song where she's giving us this very like big presence in her lyricism. A lot of power, a lot of like self-love, all the things that we sort of forget about sometimes in music because we're so busy, you know, listening to stuff where we're sad about our relationships, or we're, you know, putting out our different like opinions and feelings about, you know, our heartbreak and all of these things that are obviously very real. We have somebody here that's doing the complete opposite, taking ownership of the relationships in her life, taking ownership of the different things that she may go through in her life, and overall, like having a chance to be the one in charge of everything. And I love that and her approach so much. I can't get over it. So I'm so glad to see, especially because I think there was like a Galaxy Fold phone, so it has to be pretty new. I'm just glad that she's around right now. That's fucking cool. This is A Un Beso. Tú, transparente, sin un as bajo la manga, sin un truco, pero magia en la mirada. Oh, shit. Flor marchita que de tanta voz salada se secaba y hoy el sol brilla. Okay, so one thing I already love about this track is that we are getting something different from what we've heard already, right? Because we had these very upbeat dance sort of style anthems, and now we're getting a chance to hear a little bit different of approach. We're getting a chance to hear this almost like ballad style sort of thing, a little bit slower tempo, and I'm glad because we're going to get a chance to really hear her vocals. Oh yeah, her vocals are so fucking good. Plus, like, New York is fucking so sick, so like what better way to have a video?
Won't step from going crazy. Show me barrender, can't even
Okay, so judging from the lyrics here, I'm, you know, trying to figure out what's really going on in the song. And I think where I'm getting at is it seems that she's like been with this person or like been, you know, considering if this person would be somebody she'd be willing to have this relationship with. And it seems to me that through that like discovery of trying to figure out if it would be right or wrong, she's considering like, you know, should I walk away or should I surrender to this person? I never thought that I would be in a position to where I am one kiss away from giving up like where I stand with it and just falling in love with this person. Again, you know, coming off of the two power songs that we had, I love that because it does show that even though she's all about this power and energy and, you know, dominance over like the things in her life, at the same time, she's also not like immune to falling in love, immune to, you know, being a little bit more defenseless and vulnerable and falling in love that way. So good. Oh, dude. She has so much strength in her vocal too, even in that high range. Okay, let me give you my opinions right here about her. So, starting off with Kaya 2, I was already in love with her approach. I felt like her being able to basically say, look, you can talk all the shit you want about how, who you're going to be, the person you're going to become. I don't care. I'm not interested. I'm done. I'm moving on. I'm happy. You had your chance. I already love that. Number two, we get a chance with Caprichosa. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong. And in that, she's saying, I have the power to do whatever I want in my life. I can manifest anything that I want. I can have you fall in love with me if that's what I want. But even though we may fall in love at this moment, I'm not promising you anything long term. I'm not promising forever, because if I change my mind, I'm going to be on to the next thing, and you need to be okay with that because that's what's going to happen. And I love that because she's being upfront about her feelings, but at the same time, she's making it very clear that the intention is what it is. There's no hidden messages. And I love that she's able to dominate that power. Now, getting into the third track, A Un Beso, it sounds to me that she's like, look, this person has been trying so hard to woo me over, you know, possibly to the point that they were going to give up because I wasn't there. Yet, who would have thought that I would be at a moment in my life where we're one kiss away from this being everything, like us being together, no more game, no more chase or anything like that. I love to see the different approaches between the first two songs and that song, because it does show a level of vulnerability as well. You know, being real is having those emotions and being able to, you know, put out into the open your relationships and love and things like that, and being able to make songs out of it. But at the same time, we also get the attitude from her of being able to own your life and own the decisions that you make and decide who's in your life. And I feel like more people should be kind of giving that power too, because sometimes when I listen to a song, I'm looking for that motivation on how I want to live my life. And so to see her style and like her attitude and approach to life, so sick. I love her vocals so much. I could listen to her all day. My favorite video definitely was the last one, just because I love New York so much. And so to see her shooting like just all over the place, not just at places people know, but everywhere in New York, was really cool. I don't know, it's kind of fun to see that. So I want to give a huge shout out to Brenda on Patreon for introducing me to this artist, because holy shit, I feel like there's so much to unpack with her music, and that's only 3 tracks. So I hope you guys liked it. Let me know in the comment section what you think of this artist. That way I know if I should do more from them. Thank you guys so much for your support. It means the world to me. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.